Welcome back, everyone, to Let's Play Shadows of the Damned. Last time, we began our adventure with Garcia and Johnson as they went into the underworld to follow Fleming to rescue Paula. And now we find ourselves on this rather ghouls and ghosts-looking map, starting Act 2-1, Act 2 out of 5. Act 1 was very short, just the introduction, but the following acts will be much longer.
This is your old barrio, right, Johnson? Then you can be my tour guide.
Me? But I quit the whole demon thing ages ago, and really, my memory's absolute rubbish.
Oh, I'm sure it will come back to you in no time. Relax, amigo. This is going to be an adventure. Our very own road movie. And the best part is, you never know what's waiting around the bend.
And now that we've arrived at the gates to the underworld, and now that there's absolutely nothing behind us, there's only one way to go, and that's forward.
Well, it won't be on this side of the door.
All right, let's start this road movie with some road kill!
That's right, G. Don't let all that peace and quiet push you around.
Huh. When demons hear the name Garcia fucking Hotspur, they run the other way.
Oh, well, there's Fleming's castle right there. It's in plain sight, but it's very far away. We have a lot of ground to cover before we reach it. But at least we've entered the underworld, which is a rather
Johnson,
dark...
Johnson, what the hell is that thing?
Holy cow! I don't believe it! Willie! That's one-eyed William!
Friend of yours?
Are you kidding? William is my aunt's first husband's adopted son from the Ukraine!
Then you are practically brothers.
Willie acts as our checkpoint throughout the game, and those are the checkpoints he leaves behind.
We can't see shit up ahead.
The underworld be a shadowy place. Anyway, not a problem. Take a look over there. You see that lamp?
Hanging on the wall?
I can light that up for you.
The light shot, of course.
Give it a try, G.
Johnson says the underworld is a shadowy place, and that's because the game features a light versus darkness mechanic.
There! Did I brighten your day?
What can I say, Johnson? You are the right tool for every job. So when do I get to light up some demons?
And I'm sure you'll have your chance. They hate my light shot. Leaves a nasty rash.
The Johnsonpedia that we see just gives us entries about various things in the game, such as weapons, enemies, and items. Maybe we'll be taking a look at a few of those later on. Alright, basic zombie demons. Much like what we already encountered. And that's what the light shot does to them. It stuns them for a little bit.
Ka-ching! Save up those white gems, G.
The white gems are the currency of the game. Obviously, we want to collect as many as we can. The light shot by itself won't actually kill the demons, but does allow us to do certain other things. For right now, however, the boner is good enough on its own. We can just one-shot these demons.
These demons are not very talkative.
What have they got to talk about? Once your soul rolls into town, that's it. You're damned. And Fleming doesn't let anybody off the hook.
He sounds like a real dick, Tater.
Aha! Yes! The humor of Shadows of the Damned. By the way, here's what we can do with the torch. If we charge it up, and that will do a one-hit kill for on basic demons. Nothing in our items as of yet. We do have one other weapon, though, that we start off with. And we'll take a look at that the next time we encounter an enemy.
Johnson, why is there a goat head hanging on the wall?
Oh, well, everybody knows that goats are a source of light.
Right, of course.
And those goat heads are going to become our new best friend as we go through the game. We'll be seeing them often. And hold on, corpses. Corpse physics. Let's try...
Magnifico!
Didn't actually do anything to him. Let's try our other weapon, the monocushioner. You can think of it as the shotgun equivalent of the game. It fires skulls.
Poor Tyke. Most new arrivals in the underworld are condemned to guard doors like this for the first 100 years. We all have to start somewhere.
Garcia?
Paula? Come back!
Oh, that was easy. Let's go. We're gonna win the game right now.
Paula!
Easy, G. This place is full of deceptions and dirty tricks.
Is that a floating...
Strawberry! Oh, gimme, gimme, gimme! Oh, these things are like demon catnip when I was little.
Johnson, do I take this strawberry?
Yes! Jeez, excuse me for having a little fruit fantasy.
I kind of like that they talk about the items in the game and, ramen. Screaming ramen, I think that's it. I like how they talk about the items in the game, sort of the abstract nature of them, which most games will ignore. But that child's head seemed like it wanted a strawberry. We just picked one up, so let's go show it to it.
Hey! Don't you dare give my strawberry to that sprog on the door! No! Gee, you berry squanderer!
Right, so those baby heads are locks. The strawberry was a key. Or whatever the child head will want will be a key. In that case, it was a strawberry.
Ah, drinks. At least there's one good thing about the underworld.
What, liver damage?
That's the beauty of it. In the underworld, you don't die from drinks. They unkill people here.
I'm still not really getting the idea of dying in the underworld. I mean, I know we've been killing demons, but what happens to them? Anyway, drinks are our health.
Paula?
Hmm?
Paula?
It'll be her this time. Just right through that door. Oh.
Ah, que es esta mierda?
Right, so you might have noticed... Oh, that is pretty nasty, isn't it? You might have noticed that, Garcia was fooled by that twice already.
I was afraid of this.
What? Why is it suddenly getting dark?
This isn't ordinary darkness. If you stay in it too long, it'll suck the life out of you. Quick, use the light shot on the goat head. You can't stay in the darkness like this. It eats away the flesh of mortals.
And here's the dark part of the light versus dark thing.
Hurry, hit it with the...
How did you know shooting a goat would banish the darkness?
How did you not know? Some demon hunter, I say.
Just warn me if I have to fuck a horse to unlock a door, huh?
Well, it is a Suda game, so let's not get ahead of ourselves. So the darkness thing is going to be something we encounter a lot through Shadows of the Damned.
Paula? Is that you? I can't see for shit.
Ahem. If only there were some way to shed light on the situation.
Don't mock me, bitch.
Just use the light shot on that lamp. Sorry.
It's a good thing for us that Johnson just happens to be able to shoot these light shots. He is a demon himself, so I don't know why he'd be able to do that. How do you think Johnson feels about killing his own kind? It has to be feel pretty rotten.
Themselves! It's what's for dinner.
Demons have to eat. Or else maybe they'll starve to death in the underworld. I still don't get that. Do you go somewhere else if you die in the underworld, or just stop existing? You know, that's probably a bit too deep for Shadows of the Damned. Maybe I shouldn't ask about that.
Chingada madre, not again!
And this time there's no goat to save us. Quick, the door! Run through the door! Oh, much better. No darkness and, dare I say it, no demons.
We won't always be so fortunate as to have a goat head right next to us. Oh. Poor guy. This is just sort of getting us ready for those times when we'll be in a more difficult situation with the darkness.
Demons do love their darkness.
Then why don't they just cover the whole underworld in it?
Too much of a good thing can kill you. They say to wear sunblock in your world, right? Same idea.
I don't think that's equivalent, though. Because if it was, wouldn't there be kind of some kind of dark version of sunblock here? Dark.
What the fuck? Why won't this demon die?
Don't waste ammo. The darkness is protecting it. Only the light shot can burn that protection away. Nice one, G! How'd you know to use the light shot on that demon? Are you sure, tall guy?
Right, so Johnson says that only the light shot can take the darkness away from the demon, but something else can, hitting him with Johnson itself. Now, let's try a charged-up shot. Right, so that can do a one-hit kill. And you can't hurt a demon that's protected by the darkness. You do have to get rid of it first.
There's the goat head! Out the window!
This also means we can't really kill demons while inside darkness. And let's switch to the boner right now, because we do have more ammo for it.
Garcia.
That was Wither when she picked out that lingerie.
You? In a chick tour?
Are you fucking kidding me?
Keep running! There's no way to disperse darkness this thick!
Right, and sometimes you just can't get out of the darkness in time before it starts hurting you. So, let's get our health back with some liquor.
Pinche cabrón! Motherfucker!
More darkness dead ahead! At least we're standing on the bright side of things this time.
If you can call this bright.
Barrel here. Always remember to shoot the barrels. And there's a wall of darkness on this side. You just go through it and see what's on the other side. And back. And forward. And back. Right, so most of the time areas of darkness will be separated by a wall like that. And I've got a new enemy, masked demons. You can probably guess what the masks do. They protect their heads from headshots. Their attacks are the same as normal demons, but they're really not a big deal, even though we do have to shoot them more because of no headshots. The light shot still stuns them all the same. We really could go with a more effective way of killing them, but I guess you could say that was the hard way, just shooting them in the body with the boner until they die.
They're bleeding. Better check your goat, Dar.
We'll take a look at perhaps a better way of doing that next time we encounter one of them.
What the fuck is that?
Let's go with big and hopefully dead demon, shall we?
Hey, there's a thing. It's gonna shoot at us. You know, not to take away from the fight here, but I do like in a couple places so far we've seen penny farthings leaning against the walls. I'm just wondering, do the demons ride those? I guess someone would have to, right? And, wow, this is getting pretty loud. It's getting really loud. So like I said, right now we're just using the basic boner here. There are more complex, advanced attacks, I guess you could say.
Strawberry!
Oh yeah, there is. By the way, the boner's called that because it fires bones, in case you were wondering. Oh look, it's a tavern.
Underworld has a pub?
That's right, and vending machines too. If you're damned, you're going to need convenient access to drinks pretty much 24/7.
You know, it occurs to me that this game pretty much LPs itself. I was about to mention that there was a bar in the Underworld, but they did it for me. So, from the absinthe vending machine, we can buy alcohol. I don't want to do that because I'd like to save the white gems for something else that we'll see. And we find plenty of alcohol anyway as we walk around. He wants a strawberry. We did see one behind that gate, but the gate is locked, and he wants an eyeball. Let's see if we can oblige him. Oh look, new demon. The horn demon is a bit tougher than the normal one. Still not too much to worry about, because he just kind of stumbles around and pretty much is the same kind of attacks. Oh, there's our
gem. What does this do?
Shh. Keep it down. That's a performance enhancer. Very shady. Very, very illegal.
That just kind of brings up the question of what the legal system is in hell. Alright, but we got red gems, and that means we can upgrade our weapons. Now, there's a few different things we can upgrade, different categories, but whenever I play a game, I kind of want to upgrade the damage at all times. So, each of these gems are going to go to upgrade our boner. Make our boner more powerful, you see. What? It fires bones. Each of the weapons fires a bone or a body part. That's why they're called what they are. What would you call it?
So, Johnson, do you eat eyeballs too?
Perish the thought. It just so happens I'm a fruitarian, thank you.
Eat this!
This game is pretty linear. There's not too many ways to go.
These human hearts let you withstand the darkness longer.
I'm not even going to ask how that makes sense.
Probably a good idea. So, we're being hurt by the darkness, but it's introducing the power-up that lets us survive the darkness. I think, however, this is probably a good point to cut the video off, and we'll follow Garcia and Johnson's adventures next time. However, I thought that what might be a good idea is to take very short looks at the games that the creators of this game were responsible for. So let's start off with Shinji Mikami's Resident Evil 1.
Is that Jill?
Is that voice Enrico's?
Yeah?
You're alive!
Wait there!
Resident Evil was a landmark title which made the term survival horror a thing in video games. RE was one of Capcom's early attempts at making the switch from sprite-based games to polygonal, and probably its most successful. Reactions to RE seemed to be divided into two groups. One group loved the tension of running around in a monster-filled mansion using a style of gameplay not seen before. On consoles, not seen before on consoles. The other group hated the game due to the control style, dubbed tank controls, which for better or worse became a standard control style for the survival horror games that came soon after RE. While the game is remembered for its control scheme and its graphical style of overlaying polygonal characters over pre-rendered backgrounds, Resident Evil is probably associated mostly with its voice acting.
Now it's Wesker's time to disappear.
Which is either horrible or incredible, depending on what you're looking for.
It's Forrest! Oh my god! Oh, Jill, this house is dangerous. There are terrible demons. Ouch!
Jill, so you're safe.
That's what I was going to say. Where on earth have you been?
It's pretty obvious that RE was a first attempt by Capcom at this type of game, as everything has this kind of rough, unpolished feel. Some might not like it, but I think it adds to its B-movie nature. It also has a much smaller scale than its sequels, with the entire game taking place inside the mansion. A speedrun of the game can be done in 1 hour. Despite its flaws, Resident Evil did create a lasting legacy, and its success motivated the creation of more horror games than had been seen before in video games.